Hi guys, my name is Char and welcome back to my channel. Notice anything different?
No.
Well, I'm gonna give you a hint. It's new. Well, you guys are right. Or hopefully somebody watching guessed. Anyway, yes, you guys are right. I am in a new place. This is actually my new apartment. I moved again! This is like the fourth time that I have moved, and I've been only living in China for 3 years. Imagine that. Anyway, I am not ready to show you my apartment just yet, but I will. Today's video is all about how to find an apartment here in China. Because I said this is like the fourth time that I have moved to a new apartment. So I know that is so hard for a foreigner or an expat here in China to find an apartment. I would like to share with you guys the ways that I have tried or used to find an apartment here. I guess the most convenient and simplest way to find an apartment, whether you are in China or you're not, is to ask your company or your school for help. That's what I did the first year I came to China. I asked my company to help me find one. I gave them a list of preferences that includes my budget, living conditions, and you know, preferred location. And they did help me find one. They helped me find a really small apartment. It was about like 30 square meter apartment. And it was quite affordable. It was the cheapest that we could get due to the location. So I guess this way is very simple and very convenient because you don't need to really talk to the landlord by yourself. Your boss or your company would do it for you. Hopefully they won't go through an agency. Mine did not. So you won't need to pay for agency fee. You just need to pay for everything else by yourself, like, you know, building management fee and Wi-Fi and all that kind of stuff. You could actually negotiate the price and the payment method. My boss helped me negotiate the rent down to 17 grand. Originally it was 24 grand a month, and then she helped me negotiate it and ask for a monthly payment instead of a yearly one. So I guess it is, like I said, the easiest, most convenient way to find an apartment. But you know, you still need to rely heavily on your Chinese friends, your boss, and your colleagues. So maybe that's not a way for you. So if you don't want to ask other people for help, maybe the second way would be better for you. So the second time that I have moved to a new apartment, I tried to do it on my own because, you know, I'm a big girl in a big city. I joined a lot of, you know, apartment rental WeChat groups here in China. There are tons. Like, I joined like 5 WeChat groups. Sadly, I did not find an apartment to my liking using this way, but I did learn a lot. I've learned a lot. I've seen a lot of apartments. You know, there are different kinds of apartments here in China, like for rent. There are shared apartments. There is like, you know, you could rent an apartment, like a 3-bedroom apartment all to your own. I've learned about the price range for service fees or agency fees. I've learned about price range for certain locations. When joining this group, you are not only joining in with other foreigners, but you are also joining in with other agents there. So be careful, I guess, when you talk to other people. You need to ask them if they're an agent or are they looking for a roommate for themselves. The reason why I don't really like, you know, these kinds of groups is that because the price of the rent is really, really expensive. Like, God. let me give you an example. Let's say a bedroom in the city posted in those groups would cost around like 8k to 10k. That's a lot, especially if it's your first year here in China. But if you ask your Chinese friends for help, maybe they could find you a cheaper one with the same size of the apartment. You could do it this way, or another way that I did was going around the location that I wanted to move in and looking at, you know, ads posted on the walls. That worked for me for my second apartment, actually. I went to that location and looked for, you know, ads posted on the walls, and I tried to call them. But again, you're not sure if you're talking to a person or an agent, so you better ask again. By this way, you need to have a very good Chinese, I guess. You know, you can communicate in Chinese, you can understand Chinese, so your Chinese level must be right up here. I guess my Chinese level is right up here. It's almost getting there. Because, of course, the numbers posted on those ads, they belong to a Chinese citizen, and most of them can't speak English. But again, you need to be careful as well when you're gonna do this, because this is a little bit dangerous because you don't know where they're gonna take you, so you still need to, you know, take precautions.
bed.
That's how I look for an apartment. But it was okay. Guess I'm lucky. Yeah. So those are the hard part. That those have a lot of trial and error, and these are time consuming because you need to really put a lot of effort into talking to agents and looking at the apartments or having someone to go in the apartment to look at it for you. So if number two and number three still does not work for you and you feel that you don't have enough time, you're not in China, the prices are way too expensive, you could try method number four.
It's gonna be on the next video because there are a lot of Chinese apps here in China which I need to explain in detail.
So those are the ways that I have used to find an apartment here in China. Comment down below and let me know which way is suited for you. Again, my name is Char. I create ESL expat guides and lifestyle videos here on YouTube. If you're into that content, consider subscribing, liking this video, and hitting that bell button. Okay, I'll see you guys next time.